Bama fans, your time has come. Welcome into our day three coverage of SEC Media Days here in Hoover. The Crimson Tide faithful, they were up bright and early waiting for their team to arrive.
They definitely were. Some of the fans were down there at 6 o'clock in the morning, and the reception that the Tide got when they got here was honestly loud enough to wake up someone staying on the top floor of this hotel.
Bama is looking to bounce back this season after losing to Clemson in the national championship game.
So what is Nick Saban, a guy that has won 6 national titles, doing to get over a loss like that one?
I don't know that you ever get over things like that. I think that we obviously looked at the game several times and tried to analyze the things that didn't go well. I think more about the games that we've lost, whether they're SEC championship games that we lost, games that we lost in a national championship game, things that we could have done differently.
I think it was good that we lost, because what can you learn if you can't learn as much? You know, and so being that we lost, I think it was a good part in team entirely, because a lot of us have come back, you know, and it's something that you don't take for granted now.
Rocco, both Nick Saban and Tua Tagovailoa have been pretty banged up these past 365 days. Tua dealing with a knee injury, an ankle injury, and most recently some hamstring tightness that kept him out of the Manning Passing Academy in June.
Yeah, as for Coach Saban, he underwent successful hip replacement surgery in April. Here's an update on how both of those guys are doing.
I actually have to produce a not to hit out of a sand trap with a gust, and I really make a good game on the first tee, so I don't want to say that I'm really 100%, but I really am.
Whether I feel do it or I don't, I mean, training room more than I think I could ever imagine, and I'm not even hurt. So the times that I was hurt, I mean, I was in there a lot. I'm in there more, so.
It's no secret that each and every year, Alabama has one of the top defensive teams in the country.
Yeah, multiple NFL players and Butkus Award winners have worn that Crimson Tide uniform, and Dylan Moses hopes to be the next man up. The junior linebacker was asked what he thinks makes up a signature Bama defense.
What Coach Saban says all the time, if guys come in and we win games, and there's a lot of attention towards the team, and that'll bring, you know, awards and all that. Like, it'll come on its own.
So, Olivia, Alabama has officially left the building, but that doesn't mean that we won't hear from the Crimson Tide later on tonight.
That's right. We're going to have more on the Tide tonight at 10. Plus, we're also going to hear from Errol Thompson, one of our local guys, on his first experience here at SEC Media Days. In Hoover, for Rocco DeSangro, I'm Olivia Whitmire, WHNT News 19 Sports.